you know, they will address them with their titles and the last name most times.
Last names, yeah.
And I didn't have a chance to live into the community with them, so I can't place the first name to them. Maybe I've heard Bobby or Sam, but whatever the situation is, I know I'm Connor Dixon is okay. The name.
I just want to take you from what Commissioner Stewart said to establish that the little that we can contribute to this process is important. Some people think their stories or their experiences don't mean much. Here you are. You are in prison, you saw those two Nigerian journalists. And the issue of those journalists was made very popular when the Journalist Association in Nigeria sued President Taylor when he was in Nigeria to account for those two journalists. You know, and nobody knew what happened, just as Steve was saying. But your testimony has thrown some light that he spent time in jail and perhaps the staff or something like that. So their families, wherever they are, when this is released, we understand, at least get some information. And those are some of the things that people are looking forward to. That's why we encourage everybody to come, and we are immensely grateful that you took your time to come and share with us. Is there anything else?
Yeah, in conclusion, I'm happy you gave me this opportunity. You may not be able to do some things you may be able to do, but it's just a recommendation and a plea to the Liberian people and the government for who you represent here today, that the American people did come to our aid when God's time is the best, like we always say, when the Fed, it was time, and they did what they thought was right. But I want us as Liberians to know that a lot of us that came over to America on repatriation came raw. I'm going to break the English word down, raw. Some of us came from being child soldiers straight to America. Some of us came from being wives of men our father ages, the pregnancy, the teenage pregnancy, and sleeping with little girls in the war was so popular. And our family over here tried to bring us over to safety. So we came with those mentality. Today, our Liberian kids are lingering in prison. And until we do something about it, let us all know those are spouses of war too. That they came with no knowledge, they came with no understanding that they were coming to a totally different land with law and order. They came with a mentality of no law and order because they grew up in a country with no law and order. When the war started, some kids were 4 years old. They grew into the war, and they knew nothing but war. And they were repatriated over to America with the notion, the idea of war. Today, they exhibit those same attitudes, and they are lingering in prison. I will plead with the Liberian government to do whatever it can to do something about the youth in prison, the Liberian youth in prison. They are not held responsible. They may be guilty of crimes. Some of them are serving true guilt, but others are our fault as elders who led them into war and made them grow up in war and know nothing but war. And we cannot sit calmly and let them die while we are at fault only because we were fighting for one thing, power, position, and grief. Today, our nation will not know anything because of that. I want to thank you, and God bless you, and have a safe trip back, and may God help you to carry on his work in Liberia.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I'll leave. Okay.